Hello.
I'm not sure if the music's a bit loud, so if it is, just let me know and I will turn it down a bit. I think it may be, so I'll turn it down slightly. So, if you were with me last night, we were painting Pocahontas. You can see her there. So she's nearly... Oh, my stand just went down. She's nearly done. It's just her clothing that needs to be done. And then I'm hoping to move on to a second character during the same stream. So, as usual, I forgot to get my reference image ready. So I will just grab that now. I've still got it from yesterday. So it's just a couple of minutes to... make sure my screen doesn't time out on me. But it's quite straightforward. Her clothing's like a light yellow. I need to put some detail on her necklace and then she's done. So that is good news. Okay, so I've got my reference image ready. So the first thing I'm going to do is mix up a grey, and that's so I can finish off her necklace. So just grabbing a bit of black, didn't really want too much. Oh, so therefore I have plenty. And some white. Ooh, there's paint all over the pot there. The white never wants to come out. Come on, white, out you come. I did squeeze out quite a bit of white there, but I do tend to go through quite a bit, so that's fine. And then I want the smallest bit of blue, just because there's a very slight bluish tint to the metal on the end of her necklace, but it is literally just like on the end of my paintbrush. So just mixing grey. Oh, white paint on everything. So, I don't need a massive amount for this. I really don't want a lot of blue or black. But yeah, that's looking pretty much how I wanted it actually. And I'm going to mix a very slightly highlighted version of it as well. Probably can't quite tell on the palette, but it will make all the difference when doing the necklace. So she's got these lines coming around the corner of the necklace here. Just here and here. She's got two here. I assume this is where it would have been made and strung together. And then two on the other corner as well. And then we're going to fill in the pendant on her neck. So this will tidy up all these lines down here as well. I am using quite a small brush. It's mainly because it's my fave. I'm sitting quite far back, so I may need to adjust momentarily. I was trying to leave space for the camera. Oh, I can come in quite a bit actually. Just didn't want to knock the camera. If I turn this round, you can actually see the canvas as well, which is helpful. So I did that with the darker colour. I think the very first part here I did with the highlight, and the rest I did with the darker colour. So just giving that a rinse off, and we will grab the highlighted colour of that grey. Just go over these bits here. So it may not look like it's making that much of a difference, but as it dries, there'll be a divide between the top and the bottom of the line. Oh, just picked up the wrong colour. So grabbing a chunk of this highlight now. Her necklace goes in two layers. She's got the outside of the pendant and the inside. So what I will do is mix a darker colour just as like a liner. Just to show that there is a shape to her necklace. Okay. Cool. That was quick.
Welcome to Rivendell, Frodo Baggins.
Hiya, Eric. Thank you for your follow. I hope you're having a good day. Feel free to join in the chat if there's anything you wanted to discuss about anything. Art, life. So I'm just going to mix up a colour for her clothing. Now, it's actually a very similar colour to her skin, which, if you were watching yesterday, was challenge enough itself. So I'm going to grab some yellow. I'm going to grab quite a bit actually. And I've just completely coated my brush in paint. And I'm going to take the warmer brown, so the burnt sienna. Oh, why can I never open this pot? So I'm grabbing some burnt sienna, I'll put that on the other side. So the reason I use these tubs, they're basically like Tupperware takeaway pots, is because the acrylic paints, when they dry, they just peel off, so you don't have to sit there washing your palette all the time. Basically just wait for it to dry. And so I've got quite a stash of them that I rotate through. But they are incredibly handy. So I'm taking a good chunk of the brown and a good chunk of the yellow, and then I'm going to mix them to a much lighter colour with the white. And we should be on the right lines. The good thing about doing the clothing is, unlike the skin, it doesn't have to be perfect, because there's a little bit of room for artistic license. Whereas with the skin, you couldn't really get it wrong. It's got to be recognisable at the end of the day. However, this colour's looking pretty good actually. Yeah. Oh, that was handy. So, just making sure if there's any bits that haven't been mixed in. We don't want them mixing themselves in when we've already got our base colour on. Okay, that's looking good. Boom. Okay, just giving the brush a quick wash. So I'm going to put a base coat of this colour on, see how it dries. And if it dries a bit dark, it's kind of handy, because then I can mix in some white and get a more of a highlight. So the reason I'm using this smaller brush is because we've got some pretty accurate lines to be making now. Mainly because I probably could rescue some of her skin colour I mixed yesterday to fix it up. I really don't want to have to. We can get it right first time. Why make life harder? I think it is going to dry a bit darker than anticipated, but that is fine. It's easier to get some white in there and highlight it. Probably painted over my lines to make sure I was not leaving any white gaps. Bigger brush. I'm getting to areas now where using a small brush isn't very practical. I think I love this brush. Winsor & Newton, I think it is. Yeah, so Winsor & Newton one, I think it's actually a watercolour brush. But I use it with my acrylics and does a good job. Headphone cord stuck. So there we are. We see progress suddenly increases rapidly. Switching brush. So this is going to need a second layer. So that's fine. We can cope with it. So just quickly switching back to the smaller brush just to get the details in. What I do is basically go around those outer edges with the smaller brush and then fill in with the big brush. what has everyone got planned for their weekend then? I'm going to do a bit of streaming this morning and then take the dog for a walk. And then me and my stepdaughter are going to attempt to make fake wounds, like special effects stuff, for no reason other than because we can. I think I might bring this down more. Reason being, it looks odd. And anatomically, I mean, I'm not sure the Disney princesses are the perfect example of anatomical accuracy when you see how tiny they are. Okay, so we've got her skirt down here and she starts to overlap Merida's hair. You see? Yeah, so Merida's just here. And she's got this like fuzz of ginger hair. So we're gonna overlap that hair slightly because Merida's in the foreground, so I'll be able to paint over Pocahontas' clothes. I wanna give myself some breathing space to be able to put some stray hairs and stuff in. I don't want it to be just like a big clump of hair for Merida. Just got the seam line, which I'll paint in later, but I will leave a slight gap so I know where it is. Otherwise there was no point in sketching it. Made a mistake there, but it's probably healthier for her to have some hips. So I'm going very roughly over that line so I can still see it, but it's not white there. So I think I've probably made her a slightly healthier weight than she is in the reference image. But hey, maybe it's after she's met John Smith and, you know, she's comfortable. Let the girl enjoy her comfort eating. Right, so these sort of tasseled bits are much lighter in colour. see it a bit better. Weird because the black paint stays quite tacky, quite sticky, whereas all the others don't. So both of these clothing colours are going to need another layer. You may need to mix up some more colour, but we'll see. Grab a slightly larger brush again. In there, and that little belt I'm going to do right at the end because I'm going to need to mix up some more colour. Just double check my huge job. Dog is apparently barking at people. We live next to a pub, so the likeness is someone dares to go to the pub past our house and the dog tells them more about the fact that you can see them. Right. So I am going to try and mix up some more. Oh, I don't know actually. There's quite a bit there. Let's risk it, shall we? Let's go for a second layer. It's quite warm in here, so the paint is drying quite fast. Which is good, because it means we can get this second layer on straight away. I like using my smaller brush for several reasons, for accuracy, but also it doesn't hold on to paint. You know, like, oh look, like when you're painting a room and then you wash out the roller and there's still like a liter of paint inside your roller. Paint's a bit lumpy on her boob, which is not ideal. Nobody wants that. So one of the reasons this needs an extra layer is because I was originally going to have some Disney quotes going along the canvas, so some of those quotes are overlapping Pocahontas, but I decided against it because this is going to be a really busy canvas as it is. There was one from Walt Disney himself. Let's see if I can see the all our dreams. I think it's all our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them, which I thought was really nice, but maybe for a different canvas. Because this one is crazy. There's so much going on already. So I do want to mix a darker part of this colour so that I can put some shadows in. So I'm kind of winging it a bit, but I think this should work. Worst case scenario, I will paint over it. So it's things like here under her arm. There'd be a bit of shadow there. I'm kind of blending it in with the wet paint. Anyway. So here there'd be a dip, naturally. And here. And we'd also be seeing shadow here at the back from her hair. I'm going to switch to my small brush. I'm going to have to mix up some more of that colour. Along the bottom of these bits here, they'd be casting a shadow. So you can see I'm like dabbing at it to blend it in, so it's not just one big chunky line. And down here she'd be having a shadow cast. Made a mistake. Just grab some of the medium colour, blend that in. more around here to give her a bit of shape. So where this belt is, there's going to be a shadow underneath. It's funny, my sketch is obviously based off a slightly different reference, because I'm seeing little differences between them. And then shadow around here a bit. Cool. So I'm going to mix in a little bit more of the brown to turn it into like a liner. Just so I can define those seams. Sorry, can't quite see. Can you? So we'll see how this works. Whilst this may not be super obvious straight away, as it dries, it will dry darker. It's basically a couple of stitches to show where they'd have joined the material. Right, so now for the lighter colour, I'm definitely going to need to mix some more, but now the main part of her costume, so I don't need to worry about preserving this so much. So that's great. Think we were being burgled. Are we being burgled? Maybe. Oh, it could be the postman. It's the postman. Which, despite how angry the dog might sound, he absolutely loves our postman. And every now and then, the postman will leave a little biscuit for him. So they are like best buds. I've mixed this slightly darker colour, so what I will do is I'll carry on as I am, just basically putting a second layer on, and then I'll go back over with a highlight at the end. I still need to come back through anyway and define these different bits at the front. What you call them. I was going to say tassels, but they're not quite tassels. Or maybe they are, and they're like bunched together in blocks. Imagine animating every single individual tassel. Yep. Okay, we're going to do a live action Pocahontas. I'm not sure if they've done it, or if they're working on it now. I haven't seen any of the, do they call it reimagined Disney films yet? I did start to watch Aladdin, but I had to go out. But it seemed quite good actually. I quite liked Will Smith. Go back over that, but I'm not going to now. It's because the paint is starting to dry, so it's starting to get a bit sticky. I'm basically just gonna get that lighter color mixed and ready to go over the top. And while I'm waiting for that to dry, may as well just leave the brush in there. The belt is very similar color, but it's got a very slight black pigment in it. Yeah, that's basically it actually. So let's get this belt painted in. We need to move the camera because I'm trying to position my head around the camera and I'm making wobbly lines. Okay, cool. And then that's definitely going to need another layer. Yeah, let's get that mixed up. I don't know if you can see, I'm putting like the tiniest fraction of black in there. So it's much better to add slowly than try and take it away. So I'm going to go straight over with another chunk of paint because that was drying as I put it on. Probably because the layer I put on was so thin. Okay, I'll let that dry and then get some highlights on there. So while that's drying, let's go back over these bits at the top. Don't love this brush, if I'm honest. It's a bit damaged. take some brown and mix it into this white colour, because I want to define the edges of those tassels. Anywhere they overlap. That sounded like it was going to turn into some sort of heavy beat then. If you can see my, I'm trying not to hit the camera with my face. Because the canvas is so big, there's only so much I can really do to position everything. But it's fine. My neck will heal. Okay, they're looking good. So just the belt to finish off now. So I'm just going to grab some white and mix it straight into that belt colour to lighten it. And then just take that down and around the centre of the whole belt. Not sure what material it's meant to be. It looks almost metallic. I'm not sure she'd have had a metallic belt in these days. I don't know. Only one bit that's not sitting right with me, and that is this area here. I think the paint's too thin, so it's not got a smooth cover. So I'm just going to go over that. Excuse me. Oof. Didn't see that coming. Just a few patches where the paint isn't quite thick enough. I'm going to leave Pocahontas there. So if I zoom out, it's probably a little bit hard to see her as a whole. But there she is. She's, leave it or not, that waist is big compared to the reference image. So, she's done. Question is who to do next. So I've got, the options are, you can see the thing as a whole, already pretty crowded. So, zooming in, I've got Lady next to her there. I've got this dude from the Black Cauldron, who I don't know what his name is, or Todd from Fox and the Hound. I'm thinking Lady, but will I lean on Pocahontas? Well, I need a minute to mix up some colours anyway, and actually, Lady's colours are very similar to Pocahontas, so let's plonk that there a moment. I really need a better system for my cameras, I know. I'm currently on a Hoover. What I will do is take a quick break and get ready to start Lady. So I'll be back momentarily. I'll leave the lovely music and a slideshow for you. I'm back. Oh yes, and I moved to the campus. So let's bring you back into the floor, apparently. So that was a lovely view. Ay, ay, ay. It's one thing, when I have my slideshow on, I can't fix my camera while the slideshow is running, which is kind of annoying. Right, you're a little distance away, but I think that's probably the safest position. So, we're going for Lady from The Lady and the Tramp. Thomas Sommer. Right, so she's actually very, very similar colours to Pocahontas. So let's take this brown and this yellow. Mix them together. It's really hard to get a reference image for Lady, because I don't know where I got this reference from, but I cannot find it for the life of me. But it's fine. Any really colours I need guidance on? And I think she's going to be more yellow than Pocahontas. What I will do is switch to the process yellow rather than the cadmium hue, which means that she will look slightly different to Pocahontas. It just gives them a bit of contrast. Don't mix in with that one, please. Stay in your little area. So the difficult thing is, these references aren't the best. So let's go for a second search, just so I've got two lots of images to work with. Because actually, the screenshots from the film, her fur is a lot darker.
Dagnemic!
So again, to keep a bit of contrast between her and Pocahontas, I use a different tone of brown. So I'll be using burnt umber instead of burnt sienna. And that should help put enough difference between them that they don't blend together. Because, as it turns out, when I was sketching everything out, I didn't really consider the colours. So I did end up with a few similar colours bunched together. But I'm hoping, because it's such a big canvas, no one really notices. So grabbing some of that burnt umber, I'm going to mix that in. And darken this colour, because actually the reference from the film, her main body colour is darker, not lighter. And her ears are a warmer, reddy brown, which I'll bring back the burnt sienna for that. Ah, this is looking a lot more like her color in the film. Yeah, that's looking about right. Woohoo! Got it. Grab some more paper. I'm starting to run out of brushes. I should have cleaned my brushes when I went on my break. Grab me. I'm just saying that. I think I'm going to be limited on how many brushes I can use anyway, because it's quite a bit of detail here. So, starting off with her body. Now, one of the things I noticed is that I painted this area blue, and that was meant to be part of her body. So, if you imagine her body goes to there, she's a lot more in proportion. So, let's get that bit painted in before I forget it again. So Sully's arm hair does come across here, but I'm going to paint over it, and then when it comes to doing Sully, I can branch those hairs back over. I'm just going to double check my chat a moment. Ready. Bear with me while I try and work out what part of her body is where. I believe this is her arm as such. Yeah. It's kind of hard to see her. See, I would have saved all these reference images, but I sketched this out over probably the course of 6 months, just kind of doing it whenever I felt like it. And I didn't really think about saving my reference images because they were easy to find. Figured I'd just be able to find them again. As it turns out, in that space of time, Disney have made a live action version of Lady and the Tramp, which means that it's a lot harder to find the original image. Now, I may have made her too chunky here. I may need to cut some of that and get some blue in there. But we'll worry about that later. So this overlap with Pocahontas here is one of the reasons why I needed a colour that wasn't the same. So I'm going to grab that bigger brush. If you are watching on YouTube as opposed to Twitch, I may not be able to see any comments. So if you do want to post any chat, you will need to come over onto Twitch, I believe. Could be wrong. Now this is difficult because this kid in front, it's from Meet the Robinsons, I can't remember his name. His hair. I may just paint over the hair and deal with him later. And then I'm sure when it comes to later, I'll wish I hadn't painted over his hair. But I think I'm going to have to. Because because it's going to be almost impossible for me to figure out Lady. I'm already winging it a bit, which concerns me. So this is definitely that same. Oh, I learned on Pocahontas, I knew I would. This is quite a thin layer and you can still see the lines. I kind of need them, so that's okay for now. Getting these base colours in so I know where everything is. So what I'm figuring out now is this bit here. Which bit is dark and which is light? Because I think there would be dark fur here. Which makes me think this bit here would be dark. But would it? I can't even figure out what I've drawn here. I can see, oh, it's her collar. And so I've painted over her collar now. So her collar's there. Okay, I think that's probably fairly accurate. We'll see. So this colour's actually come out quite dark. So I'm just topping it up. And then I'm going to let that dry and then put a lighter shade of it over the top. Thank you. we need to dry because it's just moving the paint around, but that's fine. So we wait for that to dry. Need a much, much lighter, almost yellow for the front of her. You see, but in the movie, it's almost grey. There's no knowing where we're going. Oh, which way the river's flowing. Anyone know the reference? Okay, the colour's definitely looking right. This one, the front of her, based on the cartoon. So you see, this paint has much better coverage because it's got a lot more white in, and white is a much thicker paint. So reds, yellows, greens, they're all quite thin, and the browns to a certain degree as well. But as soon as you mix them with white, they thicken up loads. So quite often, if I'm doing one of those colours that are thinner paint, I'll do first base layer mixed in with white, so really like the base layer for red is pink, then I'll go over it once it's dry with a red and it'll be a much stronger colour. Thank you. I leave certain areas very slightly white so I can work out that there should be a line there. And I'll go back over that with the fine liner afterwards. So not only is she a similar colour to Pocahontas in the terms of the warmer browns, she's also got a blue collar. And what's Pocahontas got round her neck? Yeah. Poor planning this was. Maybe it was like a subconscious thing. I'm kind of going over the kid's hair, but not. His name. Can anyone remember what this kid's name is in Meet the Robinsons? Okay, so I'm going to carry on leaving those base colours to dry a bit. Now her ears, 100% in both references, are this essentially burnt sienna straight out of the pot. But we don't like to go straight out of the pot, do we? So I'm going to grab a million brushes apparently. I'm going to grab a bunch more burnt sienna. And literally just mix it with a bit of white. Just to thicken it, lighten it, make it just slightly different to what comes straight out the pot. So let's grab some white under there. So this is going to be way too light, but I'm just going to keep adding in more of the brown. So again, I'm kind of thickening up the paint by doing this, by adding in the white, and I'm controlling the shade, which just means if I do another character using the same color, the entire canvas isn't based on all of the colors just coming straight out the pot. I've also lent my arm in some paint. So currently this is quite, it's this color I've been mixing. It's still quite light and I've used all of that brown that I've just taken out. So what I'm gonna do is put that on as a base layer and then get the brown over the top. Because we're gonna need a couple of layers anyway. It's just nice to get all of the colors in the right places. The bonuses of painting the next character right next to Pocahontas. If I do make any mistakes, hopefully I can save it with paints that aren't completely dried yet. Fingers crossed that won't be an issue. These layers are going to need a second round. Some of these songs stopped really sharp. A bit strange. So I've switched to a bigger brush just because I know that I'm basically just going to be covering this entire area here. And then I get the smaller brush to go around the edges. Maybe I should have done the smaller brush first, actually. In hindsight. I also should have painted from left to right, which is one of my biggest mistakes I make. These first layers are not pretty, but it's got to be done. And the good thing is, because there are the three big main blocks of colour, by the time I've finished the third lot, the first lot should be ready for a second coat. Pardon the pun. Might hear the canvas knocking slightly. It's because I had to raise it up on a box so that I could paint Lady. Okay. So she just come out a bit too far here. So what I'm going to do is correct that as I go. Is that dry? That's dry. So I'm going to, I'm going to grab a bit of blue that I use for the background. Tiniest bit, really. Grab some white. Basically looking for a brush just to mix these together. So it'd be a ton of white, really, and the tiniest bit of blue. Too dark. And I am now going to judge this. I can bring it into there. My brush is awful. So again, this will need a couple of coats. I feel like she's coming out too far at the front. So I'll let that dry and then I'll do another coat later. And then I'll bring this in again. Dry and then do a second layer. So her main coat colour, I'm going to lighten it very slightly. But I will keep a little bit of the dark for shadow. Turns out as too dark, too light, then it'll just be around 3. Oh, that's quite a bit lighter, actually. It's still darker than the other colour, but even so. That needs to be darker. I'm making that decision now before I paint the entire thing. this time. So I'm going to bring in this colour further in here. Don't know where that black came from on my finger. Okay. So next. Light color.